Hi everyone, Joe here. It's currently the 10th of July and we've just started our third week of lockdown here in Sydney. And I just thought it'd be a good opportunity to just have a quick check-in with everyone and just make sure they understand what's happening with regard to those businesses that have been affected by the shutdown. And I know I've had a few clients asking me what payments are available to them and how do we apply. And at the moment, the details are still a little sketchy, so I just wanted to go through what we do know right now, and obviously we'll keep you updated as we find out more information. Okay, so the first thing that we can get at the moment, and this is the only thing really that you can get at the moment, is some help from Centrelink. So this is available for those of you who are earning salary and wages and effectively haven't been able to work because of the lockdown. So the payment that's available to you is what's known as the COVID-19 disaster payment. And to be able to get that, you apply for this through your MyGov account. Now to get this, you must live, work or have visited a Commonwealth declared hotspot, subject to state or territory restrictions, and the restricted movement order. So effectively, if you live in Sydney, you would be eligible for this grant if you are not working at the moment because of COVID. So you have to have had paid employment, and because you're in the COVID hotspot or subject to a restricted movement, you cannot attend work on or after day 8 of the lockdown. You've lost income on or after day 8, and you don't have appropriate paid leave entitlements, and you aren't getting any other support payments, which includes the pandemic leave disaster payment, which we'll talk about in a second, or any state-based pandemic payment. Now, up until last week, to get this, you had to have liquid assets of less than $10,000, but they are moving that away from you now, so you don't have to have, if you do have some money in the bank, you can still apply for this. There is then, if you go onto the website, there's actually dates that you can apply for this, and it does depend on what part of Sydney you live in as to whether you were eligible for the whole time or not. So if you were from Greater Sydney, you can apply for the payments from the 4th of July to the 10th of July, the 11th of July to the 16th of July at this stage, and I'm sure this will continue as we start to go on a little bit further. Now the payment is for $500 per week, and that's assuming that you would work for more than 20 hours a week, and if you work for less than that, then you'll get a slightly less payment, which I believe is $325 per week. You have to apply separately for each payment, so each week you would have to do another application for that. So if you are feeling like you're really stressing at the moment, you haven't got any work, and you really do need to access some money quickly, I know it's not a huge amount of money, but $500 is better than nothing, and you can do that through your MyGov account. I believe you can also do it through Medicare, which is also on your MyGov account, so I think you just would do it through MyGov, to be honest with you. Now, if you happen to be in a situation where you have been told you have to isolate for 14 days or you have to care for someone who's had to isolate, so that's different to those of us in Sydney who are just in lockdown at the moment. But if you have actually become a close contact and you've been told you have to self-isolate for 14 days, then there is a different payment available to you, and that's the one I just talked about, which is called the pandemic leave disaster payment. Now that's a one-off payment, and it's $1,500 for those of you who cannot work as a result of being told that you have to go into some sort of like self-isolation. So that is different. Obviously not all of you will be entitled to that, and there has to be some proof as to why you're able to claim that. But if you think that that's applicable to you, please go onto the Centrelink website and have a read of the conditions and have a go at applying for that sort of one-off payment. Because again, if you can't work, you've got to get your money from somewhere. Now, if you're a small business or a business in general and you're having difficulties because of the the lockdown, the government have announced this $10,000 grant, and it is in two different sections. So there's a grant for small business and there's a different grant, although it is kind of the same, but there's different conditions if you're in the tourism or hospitality industry. Now, this hasn't opened yet. So I know a lot of people are coming to me and saying, how do I get this? How do I apply for this grant? And it's not opening until the end of July. So you're gonna have to make do up until that point in time. They may open it a little earlier, given that we are going to be in lockdown for longer than we had anticipated. But to get this grant, there are quite a number of conditions. So I'm just gonna kind of run through those for you now. So the grant is for the small business is you have to, first of all, in any of these grants, you have to show that you've had it, demonstrate that you've had a decline in your turnover. So if you have a decline in turnover that is more than 70%, you'll get a $10,000 grant. If you have a decline in turnover that is more than 50%, you'll have a $7,000 grant. And if you have a decline in turnover that is more than 30%, you can get a $5,000 grant. Now, my question when I first heard this was, what are we comparing this to? Like, we don't actually have a clue how to work these decline in turnovers out, because if you think about it, this time last year we were in many cases in lockdown or in very restricted trading times. So if we're comparing our figures from this year to last year, a lot of the clients that I've had a look at are not really in that much of a different position because they weren't working last year either. Now the government have come back and have actually said that they the comparison is to the June-July period in 2019, and that if you were not, if that's not applicable to you because you were not operating during that period, that they're going to have some different conditions, and they haven't actually released those to us yet. But that's for those of you who were training for the last 2 years, that's what the comparison is going to be. And it will be for a minimum of 2 week period that you'll be comparing to. So maybe go back and have a look at your figures in 2019 and see what they looked like between in June, July. Now, from memory, from the first lot of New South Wales government grants that were operating last year during COVID, we had to actually tell the Revenue New South Wales what your turnover was during that period, specify the dates, and then show what the relevant time is when there was the decline in turnover in this current period. So it will be very similar. Hopefully, Revenue New South Wales will do what they did with this $1,500 grant that is available for fees and charges, where they actually provided us accountants with a template letter of what they want to see, because they will want something from your accountant to prove that these turnover figures are genuine. So we're again waiting to find out about that, but the applications aren't open yet, so we really can't do anything. Just from an eligibility criteria, apart from the turnover, you have to actually demonstrate that you're what they consider to be a small business, and that does include sole traders, companies, not-for-profits. It doesn't actually, like, you don't have to be in a specific trading structure, but you have to have fewer than 20 full-time equivalent employees, and that does include it does include businesses that don't employ people. So if you're a sole trader, you are okay to apply for this. However, if you have more than 20 full-time equivalent employees, then you're not going to be eligible for this unless you happen to be in the hospitality or tourism industry. You must have an ABN, and your ABN must be registered in New South Wales, but you must be able to demonstrate that that's where you are physically located, or that's your primary location, and you can only do one application per ABN. So if you have an ABN but you have a few different locations around, you can only still do that one application. The turnover of your wages needs to be below the $1.2 million tax payroll tax threshold, unless you happen to be in the tourism and hospitality industry, in which case you have a $10 million threshold that you need to stay under. So it's a sort of expanded grant for those of you who are in the tourism and hospitality, because they can see that this is probably where things are getting impacted more. And you also have to have turned over more than $75,000 in up to the year up to for the year prior to the 1st of June 2021. So that's actually not looking at a financial year, that's looking at a year, 12 months between June and June. Now, you can also not get this if you've got any other government support available. So if in saying that, I don't think there's that much out there, but just, you know, there is information about that. So obviously this is particularly tailored to Sydney businesses, but the tourism and hospitality, they're recognising that across New South Wales, people are not going on holidays, that their trading has been impacted as a result of this. Anyway, we'll keep you up to date. This was just a quick overview of what's happening. If you're a client of ours and you will be needing a letter, of course, we're happy to provide that for you when we have some more details. But right now, we can't do that much. All I can suggest is if you're really struggling is to try and have a look if you can get any of those Centrelink payments. And let's wait till the end of July when this grant is open and hopefully we can get some of that money for you. It does have to go to business expenses, so you'll probably need to have a bit of a plan of how you're intending to spend that money, but those expenses can include wages. So anyway, I hope you're all safe and well, and I know it's really hard being in lockdown. We've been through this before. We can get through this again, and we're here to support you however we can. Stay safe, everyone.